Hi guys, yes, we're back here for a little bit of a Rio Reacts. Declan Rice, I think it's a huge signing. And I think you've got to put the price tag away. I think we looked at Enzo comes to Chelsea, 100 million, over 100 million. This is a British record, 105 million they're saying. It took a while to get here, haggling over how the payment structure, do we want it over two payments over the course of the contract? Do you want it? Arsenal may be saying they want to pay it in four or five instalments. West Ham being digging their heels in saying, no, we want as much up front as possible. You can understand it. This is part of negotiations. I think West Ham have done an unbelievable job in getting top dollar for Declan Rice. One thing I will say, I think, listen, you can look at ability and say, are there better players in that position with better ability? Maybe you can look at it and you can argue that point, yes or no. Is it, if he's 105, what's Rodri? What's Casemiro in his prime? What's X or XYZ? You can go through all that, it's fine. I think you've got to look at more than that with Declan Rice. I think as a character, I think he's perfect. As somebody who can drive a squad on and can drive a team on, he's taken it. You can talk about the quality of the trophy that West Ham won in Europe. They've won a trophy in Europe, I don't care what you call it. They've still gone and done that. And he's been pivotal in doing that, pushing this team on as the captain, as the leader, as the inspiration. He's done that. And to do that, I don't care what trophy it is, you've got to have some level of character and personality to bring your team through them tough moments that you're going to go through. And they went through them. I think he's done his time at West Ham. I think the West Ham fans will clap him out of the stadium and out of the club and always remember him and look at him with love, which, and rightly so. But he's going to go to Arsenal now, a team on the cusp of maybe doing some great stuff and winning some silver at that football club. Him going to Arsenal puts him in a better position to win. Fact. And I just think that this kid, I think he's going to grow again. I think he's playing at a high level now. And with England, he plays at a really high level. But sometimes when you're at a club, no disrespect, like West Ham, which is a fantastic club close to my heart, West Ham, where I came through. But I saw it. I went to Leeds at the time we were trying to challenge. And you go there and the group are a better standard of player. The environment is geared up to try and win more than to just stay in the league. Not that West Ham are just playing to stay in the league, it's a bit different. But at that time with me, it was West Ham were playing to stay in the league and not much else. You love your time there. Declan Rice will be loving it at West Ham. He would have last season. What a way to sign off. But the difference is he's going to be going to a team that are going to be challenging for the league. All the big trophies they're in for, they're going to be trying to win those things. It's not about just competing. And I think that that's going to be a difference and that's going to maybe be an edge. What we need to see now is, can he step up that level? Can he go up to that level? And the expectation now, which is different, the demands on him, which are different, more is going to be asked of him maybe in an Arsenal shirt than what he was maybe doing at West Ham. Different things. The standard of his play can't have no days off. Not that he did before, but it's highlighted a lot more. You're under scrutiny a lot more. You're in the spotlight a lot more every week. Everywhere you go, they want to beat you. It's very different to when the club he's leaving to how it is looked at Arsenal. Those are the different elements that he's going to have to adapt to, and it's going to be interesting to see how quick he adapts. I've got no fear that he'll adapt to it, but it's just how quick he can do it. Does he do it immediately and walk into the Arsenal team and have that immediate impact, which he'll want, knowing him? Or is it going to take time? And the problem is, if you're a £100 million player plus, or a British transfer record, that I was once, you don't get time. You're not afforded a little bit of like bedding period. You're not afforded that. You know what? No, it's a new team, new manager, new tactics. Give them a bit of time. Listen, Declan knows as well. The knives and forks will be out waiting if things don't go well immediately. So that's a different pressure. He's never had that pressure. They're the things that are going to be different for him that he'll have to contend with. But I've got no doubt that he'll have an impact at that football club over the years, and he'll probably go on to be the captain of Arsenal at some point, because I think that's what he expects of himself. That's what he'll be demanding of himself. And good luck to him. So if they get them free signings, Arsenal, I didn't think they'll be in contention anyway. I think they will be. But that makes them serious. That I think Havertz and Rice especially would be an upgrade on what's been there. Rice will be an upgrade on Partey. Shout out Joel Bear. and Havertz for goals and assists, creativity in that 8/10 position instead of Xhaka will be an upgrade as well. The way Arsenal have attacked this, Mikel Arteta has listened. He said, I've proved that we're on the cusp of something. We've got potential to go on again and really challenge City properly to the last day maybe this time or even take the title off them. But I need reinforcements and I need you to back me. And as soon as that window's open, bang, Havertz, quick business done. Timber, who Man United were in for before they got Martinez, didn't manage to get that deal done, but he was one of the players that was being earmarked for Erik ten Hag, who obviously fancies him as a player, rates him highly, obviously, had him at Ajax. He's quick, he can play, he's good on the ball, he'll be a good addition to their team. I think he's an improvement on what they got as well. I'd probably look at it and say maybe him and Timber might play. Saliba might play. But I think it's a good battle there. If Timber comes in and they've got Saliba, Gabriel, Ben White, and Timber as a four, I'd be very, very, very comfortable with that if I was Mikel Arteta and think that's a good four. I think you need three or four good centre-backs that are going to all interchange and play at different times of the season to come in and the standard doesn't drop off. And I think that's what they'd be looking at there with them four. It'd be a great addition. Can play different positions as well, Timber. And I think they're haggling over a few million here or there. I think 45 million has been talked about. They maybe want a bit more, Ajax. But Arsenal, man. Arsenal fans, I can hear you. I can see you. You're on it. You're talking about how excited you are now for the season. I think you guys would have been excited. If I was an Arsenal fan, I'd have been excited when the season finished, when the dust settled, to say, yeah, I can't wait to next season with this team that we got. I'll be sitting going, I'm excited because of the squad that we've now got. The squad. I still think maybe you need one more, maybe an attacking player to cover those positions, especially the wide areas. Havertz maybe could dovetail out there as well at times. But I think you still need one. I think you can't afford to let Saka play another full season not missing any games. I know he missed one or two here and there, but he played too many games last season for a young kid. He's going to burn out. I think you need to save him a little bit and have moments when you can pull him out of the team and there won't be a big drop-off in output. But man, Arsenal ain't going nowhere. So Havertz comes in, I think he'll be massive. I think in that 8 position, I think he'll be brilliant there. I think I'd love to see him. I think he'll get you goals from that position. He can take the ball with his back to play as well. He can run onto things. I think he'll be even more of a goal threat than Xhaka. And that's only what's going to be good for you. I think Xhaka was great. I think he'd give you good solidity in that midfield. But I think Havertz, I prefer to see him running onto things rather than back to play, like a number 9. I like in that 8 position high up, which they do. They almost become number 10s. I think that's where he's suited. So Arsenal are on it, man. So all you Arsenal fans that go, oh, Rio hates us, etc. No, I don't hate you. I just like having a laugh because you lot put yourself in a position sometimes to be laughed at, which is lovely. And so do I. It's part of the game. It's banter. So can't wait for the season to start, guys, and we can get back on that banter game, all right? Good luck to Arsenal.